Ocala's Information Station, 1370 WOCA. Ocala!
All right, 23 minutes before 10 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. If you've ever been with a child and somebody else in the room has been reading a story or telling a story, then you've seen magic in that child's eyes, especially if it's a story that child really is interested in.
Yeah.
I want to play for you, before we speak to our next guest, a little clip, just a little bit of it from Gordon Michael. He's on the phone. He's ready to talk to us. He is a children's storyteller, and he has the voice for it too. He's got a great voice. He's got a CD collection. It's a 2D CD. It's a 2 CD set. 2.5 hours. 2.5 hours, Robin, of original children's stories that are told and not read. It says here the CD collection is called "I Remember a Story." Let's just sample this a little bit. Make sure I did all my technical stuff right here and push this button and let's listen to this. What do I do?
I remember a story about a boy named Kevin. Well, it was just an ordinary day at school for Kevin, but as the students were getting ready to go home, their teacher, Miss Miller, said she had a special announcement to make. She told everyone that tomorrow would be Bring Your Pet to Class Day, when all the students could bring their pets to school and show them to the rest of the kids. When they heard this, all the boys and girls started talking about their pets. The girl sitting behind Kevin said she had a brown hamster that she had trained to ring a little bell in his cage whenever she showed.
I don't want to do a show. I just want to listen.
Yeah, this is great.
You know, you don't have to be a child to enjoy that kind of stuff. Wow, that is well done. Gordon Michael is on the phone. Good morning, Gordon.
Good morning, Larry. Good morning, Robin.
That is good stuff. That wasn't read.
Well, thank you for that.
You just made that up on the spot?
I did.
Wow.
Yeah, and so the two CDs contain 6 stories. They're varying lengths. They take as long as they take to tell, and this is the way I started way back. And this was for my own kids, and that everyone should realize, of course, that this is not a storybook, and it's not a narration as in an audio book. There's nothing written down. It's a storytelling, and it's very different. And in fact, the very story you were playing, if anyone ever wants to experience what that's like, they can go to the website, iRememberAStory.com, and just click on the button that says sample a story, and it'll start right away.
Oh, really? So I picked the one that was the sample. Well, you were kind enough to send us the entire 2 CD set, and I'll tell the listeners in advance that I'm giving away the set that I was sent. Only problem is I've already taken off the shrink wrap, so...
I'll be happy to send one on your behalf.
And
if you want to provide the information, I'll send 2.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So give 2 away, and I'll be very happy to make sure that your listeners receive it.
Okay, so for the listeners, just to make sure, because I want to make sure we're doing the interview right, you are welcome to call in, but please wait till I ask for you to call in at the end, which is about 19 minutes from now or so. Well, Gordon, good morning. Where are you right now?
Actually, I'm currently in Montreal, Canada.
In Montreal?
Yeah.
You have a great voice.
Well, thank you for that.
You have a friendly voice and just a great radio voice, you know, even if you weren't friendly.
You can't fool a child, though.
You know, I love the fact that there was a hamster mentioned. If there's anything that'll get a kid to say, oh, I want to hear this one, it's a hamster, mm-hmm. right?
Exactly.
Well, in the story, it's actually a story about Kevin and his pet Budgie. And that's because one of the kids in the class is a little bit of a bully, a little bit of a show-off. And when the announcement is made that it's Bring Your Pet to Class Day the next day, he's making sure everyone knows he thinks his pet's better than every other pet. And Kevin figures he's got to step up. And he does have a budgie, and it is a talking budgie. I don't think he's ever heard it say a word. But he has to tell everybody that it's so talented it can say 1,000 things. And so the game is on.
Wow.
The rest is how he gets himself out of his mess.
You know, Mr. Rogers is gone. We need a new one. I think I think we should nominate you.
These stories are for boys and girls, both ages about 5 to 10.
5 to 10. How about 5 to 60? That would work for me.
There you go.
You know, the parents love them too, and it's very gratifying for me because the parents, you know, respond so generously by saying, "We just love these," and it makes me feel good.
So these are all kind of, what, is it improvised? Is that the word? Are you ad libbing?
It was all improvisational. It really started strange. I have 6 kids, and they're all 1 year apart. And so there was a given night way back when they couldn't decide on the book I would read. And so to try and solve it all, I decided to try and make up a story. And I did that. And it just worked really nicely. And I loved it. I never realized I could do it. And I think a lot of people should give that a shot because they'll realize how good it is. What really comes of this is that your kids have special memories of you telling those stories. It's not a book. It's very different. It's like a one-on-one.
Yeah.
And it's just so much fun.
I can imagine this is a hit in the car, too.
Mm-hmm.
Great in the car. Great at home alone. Great because it's something that's very portable. So
did you, did you write them down after you read them and kind of listened and then do a transcript of what you've created so that it readable?
No, not quite. So I have about 100 of them. And so I just chose 6 at random. And these are contemporary stories. These aren't sort of old-fashioned fables. These are for today's kids. And I just made notes. Remembering the story, I sort of outlined the notes, and so when I went into the studio, I just began from the top and told the story.
And how long are each of the stories? Have you timed yourself so that they're consistent in length?
They're all different. The shortest was probably about 20, 22 minutes, and the longest would be about 32 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So the 6 all taken together came to about 2.5 hours, 2 hours and 25 minutes.
So when the parent has your CD and they put it on for the child, do they sit with the child just to be immersed in the moment, or should they encourage the children to multitask and do something else with their hands, crafty or something, while they're listening to your story?
You know, there's probably no perfect answer. It can work either way. I think for our experience, hearing back from parents and kids, it starts out that way, but in the end, the kids just sort of become engrossed in the story or engrossed with the story, and they just sit there and listen to it. And oftentimes, the parents themselves get caught up in the story and want to hear it to the end. I guess the nicest thing is parents report to us that the kids just want to hear them over and over again, which was my own experience with my kids. I'd say, can you tell that one again? Can you tell that one again? And so it's nice to hear that still is the case with children.
So you remember them. You don't. I mean, do the kids remember them better than you? Wait a minute. That hamster wasn't brown.
Yeah, right.
And the hamster was blue last time.
I'll tell you what really happens is when you retell it, you always see an opportunity to add something new, and you do it. And so they pick up on that. They go, we didn't hear that before.
Okay. Yeah, you don't say, I just added it.
I'll bet your kids love you at show and tell.
Well, you know, we've never done it that way.
Tell
and
tell.
For the longest time, I didn't record any of these, and my kids were encouraging, my wife was encouraging me to try and perhaps share that, and it just one day I said, okay, I'll do that, and went into the studio and recorded them.
And by the way, the audio quality is so pristine. I mean, somebody did a good job with the technical part of that. Is that you? I mean, are you technical?
No. We had a great studio help us.
Okay.
And, so they did a great job at putting this together. And you know, there's another 6 coming behind these, so it's fun. You know, as long as people want to, as long as kids are going to be interested in hearing them, I'm going to be happy making them.
Tell me about your story creating approach. Do you try to teach a lesson? Is it simply all entertainment? What is your philosophy on making up a story for a child?
Well, the first thing is it has to be fun. It can't be anything but fun in the end. It has to delight. So you can achieve that 100 different ways. And so there's sometimes we use humor. Sometimes I use just the whole idea of an adventure. Sometimes we'll throw in something. I like to tell things that have a slight bit of scariness to them that gets resolved by something really clever. And what's really nice here is to make sure every child feels they can be in that story. They imagine themselves in the story. Because it's as much about them, it could be, as it is about the character that we're talking about.
Do you draw on some of your own history with your children as they're growing up and tell a story?
You know, I don't really. There isn't any of that in here. All of these were made when they were younger. There's one story here called Emily and the Greatest Circus on Earth, and Emily is the name of one of my daughters. So I borrowed from that because I imagined her. But there's nothing in the story that reflects anything about her life or anything. But I just chose that name because it reminded me of her.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Well,
Gordon Michael is our guest, and my bio on you, Gordon, says that you, as you mentioned already, you have 6 children. Are they all grown already?
you know, they're moving on pretty quickly. I guess our youngest is now, believe it or not, 19.
So okay.
19 through 20. Wow.
Okay, so then, yeah.
And but we still, I still tell stories. They're more adult-like because I sort of became a storyteller. And so I do tell stories, and they enjoy those. But their favorite are the children's stories. And there's a whole set that are for even younger kids, and that's about three mice, two cousins, a brother and sister, and their cousin Albert. And I must have 25 of those. And so they, here they are grown, and they still want me to tell the story about the mice. So.
Oh, that's really? Pretty cool.
Wow.
It is.
Great for the holidays.
Wow.
Are you gathering.
Are you a grandpa yet?
No, I'm not.
That'll be next.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's probably going to come, but it doesn't look like it's on the immediate horizon, but it'll happen.
So now, just so you know, Robin and I, first of all, get lots of offers to do lots of interviews, and we unfortunately have to tell some people no. One of the things that happens when we get an offer for a children's CD is that we notice that the effort is really 110%, but there are certain things that fall short. Maybe the story isn't that good, or the quality of the recording isn't that good. A lot of people try to do this, but they fall short of our standards anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not trying to say we're any big time show or anything like that. It's just that we've got so many to choose from, so we can pick the best. I want you to know that even though we've had a stack on my desk for a year, of different ones, when Rich, your publicist, called us, there was no question about it. I mean, you are top notch. Do any of these stories get broadcast? Radio Disney, is Radio Disney still around?
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
As far as I know, it is. Uh-huh. And I know that someone has invited them to consider that, but I don't think anyone has heard from them. And I should probably just finish my answer that I didn't quite do properly. You were asking if there's any message in these stories.
Hmm.
And, you know, there probably is. There's no sermonizing. But one thing that I've always felt is important is for children to discover what character means. And so all of these kids, every one of these children that make up the characters in these stories, the principal characters, they all have personal character. They have values. You see them evolve. They're simple, but you realize these people are what you want to become. And so that's about the extent to which I'll go in trying to share a message. And it's see the character of these people. They make hard choices, good choices, hard, but in the end it all works out for them. And that's what you want to remember.
You haven't mentioned it yet, but there's information in my notes for this interview indicating that you're involved with something called Children's Hospital Million Smiles Project. What is that?
Well, I created the Million Smiles Project for children's hospitals because I've worked with a lot of hospitals, and I do know the challenges they face. No matter how much staff they have, how many volunteers they have, it's never enough to fully address the needs of these kids with respect to providing something to divert their attention from their pain, their lonesomeness, even their depression. And so what I'm doing here with the Million Smiles Project is that for every set that's purchased, or for every download, because you can download them as well, I'm going to donate one to a children's hospital in the area where the person lived who purchased. So, for example, anyone in the Ocala area, it would go to the Shands Children's Hospital in Gainesville. And it'll be given to them in the person's name, not in my name. So the person who buys one for their child or grandchild, they'll know that another copy went to the Shands in their name.
Wow, that's awesome. I went to the website, nicely done site. It's called iRememberAStory.com for those who want to look it up right now. So I could actually download the MP3 right now, couldn't I?
Definitely.
Do you incorporate characters in your stories that speak languages other than English? Because sometimes when sometimes when people write stories, they not only use English, but they try to incorporate Spanish or French, that type of thing. Do you do that?
I haven't as yet, but I will tell you that one of the stories required that I try to create an English accent, because one of the stories is about Chris. And Chris is a young boy who's going to travel with his family on a business trip to London, England. And he's hoping to visit the castles and palaces of London, England. But then at the last minute, his trip is diverted because his father's meeting is transferred well out of London. And so he's stuck on an estate somewhere in a house near the woods. And he wanders into the woods and he sort of gets lost there. But he meets this old woman who at night knows he's lost and helps him get back to the house. And they become friends along their walk. And then on the last day of the trip before they head back to Chicago where he lives, they get a call saying that the company has made arrangements or received word that they can visit one palace before they return. And of course, so it's Buckingham Palace. And he returns. And who's there but his good friend, the little old lady, who's actually Queen Elizabeth, because he
realized
that they were actually staying right next to her castle at Balmoral. And so they share cookies and milk, and the parents are flabbergasted, and it's just a fun story. But it did require that I tried to fake an English accent.
Do you ever incorporate music or sound effects into the stories?
I don't. And, you know, I've been asked that before. And in storytelling, you can do it or you can't. And so I just decided to make it as if it was one-on-one, just me sitting with somebody or a few children and talking to them. And so you'll see that there isn't, with the exception of the first story you played, the very exception. And that's because at one point, Kevin's budgie, whose name is Reggie, does speak, and he says...
Oh, I like
that's
that.
That's the only sound you're going to
get.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And that's with your voice. You did that with your mouth.
I do.
Well, very fun. And this is a great gift idea. So let me, we've got a few minutes, so we can probably do this comfortably without having to rush it. We have a copy here of the two CDs in I Remember a Story, and this is perfect for anybody of any age. The recommended is boys and girls ages 5 through 10. But let me tell you something. I was enjoying listening to these stories. So let me give the one away that I have, and then I'm going to ask Gordon to remind us of what his offer was, because he did make an offer earlier. Good morning. You've got the one I have. Who's this?
This is Grady.
Grady, you've got it. It'll be waiting for you, okay? It's a two CD
right.
set.
Thank you much.
Somebody's going to love it in your family. I have a feeling. It'll be waiting for here. Gordon, remind us of what your offer was. Are you giving away one or two?
I'll give you two more there, for sure. I'd be happy to do that. Pick if two others want one, find them, and I'll send them.
All right. Well, we just need two more people to ask for them, and you've got them. But you can also go buy them. They're very affordable. Even though you can get this as an MP3, gosh, I'm torn. See, I think I'd rather have the CD simply because it's tangible.
And it's colorful. I love it's the colorful. Covers on it.
Children
very well done.
Would probably like looking at it as well. But you could download it for $14.99. I'm looking at the website right now. The two CD set costs $16.99, so it's very affordable. Let me give away one of the ones. Now, this one will have to be sent, so I don't have it waiting for you here yet. We have to wait for Gordon to send it. Good morning. You've got one of the other two that Gordon is offering. Who is this?
Wonderful, Larry. This is Kathy.
All right, Kathy. What we'll do is we'll have Gordon send it here, and we'll call you when we have it, all right?
Fantastic. Thank you, Gordon.
But we'll need to get
You're
your
very
number.
Welcome.
We'll need to get your number off the air. So, well, Robin knows how to get a hold of you. So, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you.
All right, and I've got the phone lines all lit up. Look at this. Okay, let me get another one, and then that's it. Good morning. You're the lucky third winner. Who's this?
Oh, great. Linda.
Linda, okay. And again, this your two CD set will be here. How long does it normally take to get to Florida from a mailing?
Oh, it'll be there in a couple of days.
All right. And do we need Linda's information?
Yes, I need
Linda, don't go away. We need your information off the air, okay?
All right.
Don't go away. Gordon, thank you so much for being on the air with us today, and a very light kind of conversation, which is something good now and then, right? Is it cold up there in Montreal?
You know, it's pretty cold today.
Do you speak French?
A little bit.
You must, huh? You're living in Montreal. Well, Gordon, thank you so much for being on the air with us. Have a great Christmas season if you celebrate Christmas, and you're definitely welcome back anytime.
Same to you. Have a nice Christmas, great New Year, and Larry and Robin, very much appreciate being able to today.
And remember, go to iRememberAStory.com if you want to see and hear and download or order the information we were just talking about. And Linda, don't go away. We need to speak to you off the air. All right, we'll take a little break and be right back.
Experience Christmas at Gaylord Palms, November 23rd through January 5th with Ice featuring Frosty the Snowman. Join Frosty, everyone's favorite snowman, in a colorfully frozen retelling of this original Christmas classic. Relive your favorite scenes, hand-carved in more than 2 million pounds of ice sculptures and slides, plus the all-new Artisans in Action live ice carving zone and the awe-inspiring Nativity in Ice. For tickets and packages, visit christmas@gaylordpalms.com.
How about a gift of a tree for the whole family this Christmas? It's perfect for now and for years to come. It's the best time of the year to plant a tree, and the deals are truly out of this world at Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens in Ocala. Bob says buy one tree, get the second for half price. Dozens of varieties to choose from. Prices start as low as $29.99, and they range all the way up to $300. What's more, Bob Wine's will deliver and plant many of these trees for you. Citrus trees too, dwarf and regular sizes. Buy one, get the second for half price. Come to Bob Wine's Holiday Wonderland and you'll be amazed at the deals. Poinsettias and Christmas cactus by the hundreds. Living Christmas trees. Buy one, get one deals everywhere you look. And guess what? The camellias are in bloom. Bob Wine's is a must on your holiday travel list. Bob Wine's, open daily till 5, Saturdays till 2, till Christmas. They're on Southeast 38th Street, Ocala. Now celebrating 60 years and still growing.
Got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Happy holidays from all of us at WOCA.
Hey everybody, this is Kelly Hart, your new host of the Ocala Magazine Radio Show. Join me every Friday at 10 a.m. when we bring the pages of Ocala Magazine to life with in-depth interviews from and about your community. So don't miss Marion County's favorite city magazine, Ocala Magazine, every Friday at 10 a.m. right here on 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes